Thank you so much for joining me on this CareCollab update of Brassocattleya, Jairak, Kiku. Today with, once again, honeybees and orchids and tropical plants, Finland. And I say once again because clearly this is an update on our Jairak, Kiku, but also because I consider them the originals. Back in December, 27th to be exact, 2020, the first CareCollab video ever aired featuring this orchid, Brassocattleya Jairak Kiku, together with honeybees and orchids and tropical plants, Finland. And it came about that I was doing an orchid tour or something like that, and tropical plants Finland said, oh, I've got Jairak Kiku. And I went, ooh, would you like to do a care video with me? And then honeybees and orchids went, I've got Jairak Kiku as well. And I said, great, would you like to do a care video together with us? And that was how CareCollab started. In the background, together with the two tunnels, I'm teaming up again today. So I've labeled them the originals. Thank you to both of you so very much for being so open and willing to jump on board, do a video together. Who knew that it was gonna come to the CareCollab what it is today? So to the two of you, pioneers in this initiative, thank you very, very much. Well, as you can see, my Jairak Kiku as an update is not in bloom. I wish it was. I do believe we are going to see some blooms here though, but I'm not going to tell you which channel because I'm hoping that you would go to the links in the description below and watch the videos and see which channel is going to show us blooms. I've had mine in bloom though. The first year that I got her, she bloomed for me really nicely. Then last year I had only one bud, which was kind of surprising because, you know, I had three blooms before. Why am I only getting one? And then, I have a resident gecko and he does his routes during the night. And I guess he propelled himself from one part of the trellis to the other and misjudged the distance. And I woke up in the morning with a bud in my pot, which was very unfortunate. So I have not seen these blooms for 2 years. I still not sure whether I'm gonna get blooms this year because last year I just thought, okay, well, you didn't bloom, out of the pot you come, massive root cleanup, and back in the pot you go. I did not even film that repotting because I had already done repottings of Brassocattleyas after 2 years in the self-watering setup. So I was quite radical, took it out of the pot, cleaned it up as I do, and then put it back in the pot, and here we are today. I am at least now seeing that I've got three new growths coming. You can see there's one here. There's another one right there coming as well. And somewhere in the back, there's a tiny one. It is reluctant to be anything of substance. Well, I would protest too if somebody ripped me out of a pot and did what I did. Especially these Brassocattleyas. I mean, you would think they were robust, but it seems like in my climate, I need to be a little bit more vigilant with them. Because once they've been disturbed from my setup, it's not like they adjust really quickly. So I've set this one back. I've also lost a few leaves in the process, but it's coming back. And now I'm getting some new roots, which is wonderful, all around the pot. And I have to mist it quite regularly now so that I don't lose all those beautiful roots because of my dry top layer. It still looks very red to the leaves. It was redder than this back in December. And now it is living in the shadiest part that I have in my blooming alley, which is facing south, but it is really, really on a very, very shady shelf. And even though it is so shaded and doesn't get any direct sun, except now that I'm filming it, it still has that anthocyanin. And so last year I thought, okay, only one bloom, you didn't get enough light. That was very, very strange. So I put it up into higher light. And then after the repotting, I thought, maybe not. It was looking a little bit, like I said, struggling side. So that's why it is in real shade now. And still there is anthocyanin. Maybe I'll get a bloom out of it, out of this growth. I would be very, very surprised. But at least the leaves have now opened up a little bit more. They are looking glossy again. They don't look like they are sticking in a pot and just languishing. I can get some substance into the orchid now. I can start fertilizing properly again, which I have been doing at 160 parts per million. There are viable roots in the pot, but they are tired. So you could see the whole orchid in the last 6 months was just waiting for the warmer weather. We've had a very, very mild spring. So it's all a little bit behind as to what it would normally be doing. I still flush a lot, I mist a lot, and now it's getting its fertilizer. Whether we are going to see in another update my blooms, I do not know. But again, I am almost certain, at least I'm hoping, that one of the channels has their blooms open. That would be awesome because they are gorgeous and delicate. Well, typical any Brassocattleya cross. Very, very beautiful. Thank you so much, Tropical Plants Finland, for reaching out to me, requesting a 6 month update. I really appreciate the heads up so that we can get this organized, and here we are. If you find yourself not knowing about the Care Collabs, would like to know a little bit more about what we're doing here, let me know in the comments below. I would be very happy to elaborate. If you grow orchids and post to any kind of social media, make videos, etc., you are very, very welcome to join in, not just for the Jairak Kiku, but for any other orchid that corresponds with the Care Collab database that I've got going right now. So feel free, leave me a comment below. Welcome to the CareCollabs, if I can say that ahead of time. And let's get some more channels on board with their experience regarding Brassocattleya Jairak Kiku. Honeybees and Orchids, Tropical Plants Finland, chapeau. Thank you so much for being the originals. I will always call you the originals. Thank you so very, very much. And anybody that's watched this video, your time is appreciated. Thank you as well. And I wish you a wonderful day. Please stay safe and take care. Bye.